I'm standing here with Dale Roberts. He is the director of America the Beautiful. And Dale, we just got done talking to Garen, and we talked to Chuck, and we talked to Kimberly. This sounds like just an amazing project. It sounds very ambitious. I'm sure it was pretty hard to get it done from start to finish and everything. But it sounds like it's got a really important message, too. So, I mean, what was your ultimate goal when you set out to make this film from start to finish? What did you want people to get from it?
Basically, my purpose in doing the film was to put forth the message that we're all beautiful the way that we are.
Right.
To really, so that we can recollect our self-esteem, mm-hmm. and just kind of take it back from the advertisers, because from doing this film, you know, I've probably interviewed 1,000 people, I have 500 hours of footage. Basically what I've noticed, especially with women and young girls, is that the beauty industry and advertisers have taken away the young girl's self-worth, body image, anorexia, self-esteem, everything is like kind of ballooning because they're making billions of dollars off of people not feeling good about themselves.
Right.
That's what I wanted to do. I figured if at every screening, if I could get one person to say, you know what, enough, I'm fine the way I am, that I would feel like, this is a 4-year journey.
Right.
I would feel like this journey was more than worth it.
Right. Now, did you meet any kind of opposition as you were making the film? Did people like kind of say, why are you doing this? Why are you pulling the curtain back? Or was it pretty cooperative?
It's weird. In one section of the film, we interview all the teen magazines, the editors. And it was weird because they were really supportive. It was like they agreed with what I was doing and acknowledged that that was the case. But they said, this is a business, so we have to keep doing it. So it's like they were torn themselves between capitalism and
right.
making money and what it's doing to young girls.
Right.
So everybody was supportive. That's the thing I found the most shocking. All the plastic surgeons from the TV shows, Dr. 90210, Extreme Makeover, they all did interviews. All the industries embraced what I was doing. That was weird. I thought I would have to like ambush them and kind of sneak and all that stuff. But
trick them into saying something.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It was right there.
Yeah. Well, maybe there's something to that. Maybe, you know, they want people to understand their feelings towards it. Because it's possible to work for an industry and not really respect what you do.
And I found that to be the case a lot, especially with the magazine editors. They pretty much said that. The editor-in-chief of 17 Magazine told a story about how when she was growing up, it was 17 Magazine that made her feel bad about herself.
Really?
And now she's the editor-in-chief of that same magazine. And yeah, that's what they acknowledged, the damage that they're doing to specifically young girls, but really to everybody. And think about it, what good is a society where all the young girls feel bad about themselves?
Right.
Because, you know, you can measure a nation by the youth. And then when I talk to young girls, the other thing that's happening in society, decade by decade, we've been spiraling toward an area of moral decay.
Right.
So good qualities, good human qualities, aren't reinforced from society.
Mm-hmm.
What is reinforced is $200 gym shoes,
right.
Jay-Z jackets, rap music, that kind of stuff.
We're losing our identity.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think back now, it's like when I see high school girls these days, and I think about the girls that were in my high school class, they were all unique. They were all different. Nowadays, it's a cookie cutter. Everybody looks the same.
Very monolithic.
Yeah.
You're absolutely right.
Yeah.
When I was in high school, it was the same way.
So ultimately, what could the fashion industry do to really change that? Or is that something that we still need to work on?
You know what? I had to catch myself because this is what happened. I used to promote that what the fashion industry should do is have more women size 8 to 12.
Right.
But then I thought about it. If they did that, then people that are size 0 and 2 will become now the ones with the lower self-esteem.
Right.
So I think what they need to do has nothing to do with sizing and all that. It has to do, they need to focus on things that are more important about a person than just their looks.
Mm-hmm.
Find a way to sell me a shirt not built on whether I have biceps or not,
right.
but based on the fact of the kind of person I am. And just let's leave the physicality alone, because when you focus on physicality, you have to have a winner and a loser.
Mm-hmm.
That's just the nature of it, the nature of the balance.
Yeah. The film is America the Beautiful, and I'm here with Dale Roberts, the director. Thanks so much for coming out, Dale.
Thank you very
much. Hope you enjoy your time in Dallas.
Yes.
Thank you.